But first, a violent criminal who fatally stabbed a Kilmore mother and tortured her children has been sentenced to 35 years behind bars. Just 3 weeks after being freed from jail, Sean Marafko went on a brutal rampage as his victim tried in vain to call police.
Some sense of justice at last for a family torn apart by murder and cruelty.
We have been handed a life sentence by the murderer and feel very grateful for the sentence he has been given. No sentence, however long, will bring back my daughter Joanne.
Sean Marafko smiled as he entered court, but when he received 35 years with a minimum of 30, the smirk was wiped off his face. Single mother Joanne Wicking took him in as a boarder when he was freed on parole after jail time for assault. 3 weeks later, she was dead, stabbed four times.
She and her four children were terrorised and traumatised. Two of them were injured by acts of severe and calculated violence.
Marafko held a cigarette lighter to an aerosol can, spraying an 8-year-old girl with flames. A terrified 10-year-old had duct tape around her mouth.
We have been lucky that we did not have to endure the trauma of a trial, as so many others have to, as the perpetrator pleaded guilty.
During the attack, Joanne called 000 repeatedly, pleading for help. But Marafko intervened, telling the operator they were fine. Police won't answer questions about those calls, claiming Marafko is still entitled to appeal.
If her call is being interrupted by a dominant male, which it was in this case, that would probably or should have sent off some alarm bells.
The judge described the crime as horrendous, totally repugnant to a civilised society.
After the sentence was handed down, Marafko called his lawyer over to the dock and asked him to tell the court he will never apply for parole.
We will always be left with the reason why did it happen to us.
Melanie Davies, 10 News.